Hi, I'm Lucy Reimer.
And I'm Jermaine Purifoy.
And we're here with your Bradley Beat.
Man, we are really getting the hang of it.
We are getting the hang
of it. It's coming together well.
It's coming together well.
It's coming together well.
Next time we're going to have to add like a little, you'll have to sing it a little bit.
I was about to say, we need to add some kind of melodic thing to it, you know, since people enjoy hearing me and you sing.
They do. You realize it was like exactly a year ago we had our debut. At Mossrow's Art Gallery.
You know, and that's very true. That's very true. I guess, like I said, I've had a lot of debuts, but I roped you into it. Yep. I roped Lucy into it.
So now I had my debut.
Yeah,
that.
So now everyone wants Lucy to sing, you know? So we'll definitely have to have a melodic thing.
I'm saying it one time. There was only one time that I sang.
That's all it takes is one time.
No one asked me since.
So one time.
There we go.
And we may come up with a little jingle for the Bradley Beat. I'm serious about that.
We should. It would be fun. That's what we'll work on for 2023.
That's absolutely.
Yep.
So what are we going to talk about today?
You know, we had a big week this week, didn't we?
It's already been a big week. It's been a busy month, busy week. It's been busy.
It has been. You know? And I'm still recovering from Mardi Gras. I don't know about you.
Yeah.
Tuesday was a big day at the museum.
It was a huge crowd.
That band was amazing.
Amazing. Thank you all for coming out. Thank you for everyone who helped make that event a success, because we really did enjoy it.
Yeah.
And I've heard nothing but great feedback, you know, about it. So absolutely, Mardi Gras is still going on. Mm-hmm. It's an ongoing thing.
Yep. And you know, what I think is so wonderful about this Music Under the Stars series is it always brings people to the museum that have never been there before.
Absolutely.
I love watching the ticket list come in. I'm like, I don't know that name. I don't know that name. I don't know that name. Which is such a change from the past when, you know, we kind of always, like, I knew who was going to be at each and every event.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because it was like, you know, we still have our regulars. You have your regulars. We love our regulars. The people that have supported us for years and years and years. But it's so much fun to see new people coming in and taking advantage of the museum.
That was the purpose of starting, when we started Music Under the Stars, is to bring diversity. Through entertainment, music and entertainment. And so to see that happening is really cool, because that was from the initial start when we, you know, had the idea to start Music Under the Stars. We wanted to bring about a different audience. And that's why you and I have had the conversations of having different genres and different things, because, you know, there's an audience, as I always say, here in Cleveland for everything.
Yep.
We've had so many different kinds of music come through, and we've got more to come.
Yep, we do. And so we know, we announced the date of the next Mardi Gras at, not the next Mardi Gras, we know when the next Mardi Gras is.
Oh, there's another Mardi Gras.
Of the next Music Under the Stars at the show last night. And I'm going to look at my calendar here, because I want to get it right. It is going to be in September, and it would be September 28th will be the next Music Under the Stars. And, of course, that will be in the courtyard.
Mm-hmm.
So who will be performing and what will be performing is still up in the air.
But,
you know, who knows? Like, we've celebrated jazz. I know I've said I'd love to do, you know, blues or
classical, even like
classical,
you know, even classical
gospel.
See, we've had the Sounds of Tennessee, you know, like I said, a lot of people who has an audience for barbershop. People love barbershop. So we've had the Sounds of Tennessee, we've had jazz. I know I did a Motown show years ago when
Motown
I did the Marvin Gaye tribute.
You know, that was where I got in trouble.
The first one, and then we did the Motown one, and then we did another one with Raj Chattanooga. I'm also on the board for Raj Chattanooga. We did a Music Under the Stars back in 2018 with them, and then we also had them back for our History Happy Hour.
And I want them to come back again.
Yep, because they bring such diversity.
Good gracious. They were fantastic.
Absolutely. So well attended. People still talk about that particular event. So, thankfully, you know, I have access to them being on the board with them as well. And they've been, I see them as partners with the museum, you know, me being the liaison between the two.
Yes.
So we're just brainstorming. That's the thing with when it comes to the museum. I don't think you can say there's only one particular type of thing happening.
Oh, no. There's all sorts of things. And I think that's, you know, been what's been so fun about really focusing on that cultural center piece of our business model, is that we're really getting to explore like all the different things that our community has to offer between music and art and food and beverage.
All of
the Keg, Cork, and Barrel is coming up. You know, we did Mardi Gras, and then of course it was Ash Wednesday. So now I guess for the next 40 days, you know, we've all given up all of the food and beverage.
Not me.
Probably not me either.
Not me.
But for those that do, we have Keg, Cork, and Barrel on the other side of Easter.
Absolutely.
The week after Easter. So we're excited about that.
We are.
Keeper's Quest Brands is coming back. They were there last year sampling scotch and doing scotch and whiskey tastings. So they're committed to come back. Of course, Tarver Distributing, they'll be back with their regional craft brewers. Mm-hmm. We have got Nathan and Sean will be in the VIP room playing again.
We're doing
something different in the courtyard this year. Mm-hmm. We are going to have live music in the courtyard as well.
Oh, wow. That's awesome.
And so Dustin Tommy and the Ramblers have committed. Mm-hmm. And Rob Alderman and the Unfortunate Return has committed.
Rob Alderman. We worked with Rob for many years.
And who knows? Maybe I'll just put Jermaine on the spot and make him join somewhere.
I'm always ready. If I got to jump on the stage.
Put you in the VIP room with Nathan and Sean.
You know, and I've jumped up there with him many times at the bistro and at the museum. So, I just always am prepared. If there's a microphone, then I will find my way to it.
You sure will. So that's coming up. But, now that that's over, we have to talk about the quilt show.
Yes.
We started taking quilts on February 20th. Mm-hmm. We have got a huge collection of quilts that are coming in, and the judging is happening. Mm-hmm. It happened this past Monday, mm-hmm. so we know who the winners are. Can't wait to reveal those next week. Quilt show starts on March 1st, and it goes through March 4th. Quilt show is always one of the biggest events at the museum every year. It usually draws a crowd of about 400 or 500 people over the course of the 4 days that it's going on. Mm-hmm. There is a community service sewing day that will happen. Mm-hmm. There is a lunch and learn where somebody's going to come in and talk about a specific type of quilting. That's going to be really cool. So that is coming up, and everybody should come out and see it. It's just $5 to get in and see the quilt. Now, we are a donation-based museum, and I know everybody's thinking, wait, I thought it was free to get in the museum. You can go into the exhibit hall for free and see a sampling of the quilts that are in our rotating exhibit area. Mm-hmm. But if you want to get into the cultural center where, the hundreds of quilts are on display, then that's $5, and there are vendors in there as well. Mm-hmm. And I just want to say a big thank you to our sponsor, Edward Jones Financial.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And it's, I've said before, quilting is such a craft, it's really an interesting craft. So I'm not going to go and learn how to quit. I don't think that would be good for me, but I would love to go and witness it and watch. I know.
You could go to the cigar lounge with your quilting.
my newly quilted. We'll see how it turns out first before I present it. But please get out and support that event, because I think that's something, like I said, it's a really underrated art, and a skill that I think gets often overlooked, so it's worth the $5 to go and see the masterpiece. It's just like I said, you have artists in our gift shop, all this artwork, and I'm like, man, this is stuff that you could see in other museums, bigger museums. Mm-hmm. We have it right here in our museum. And so the quilting, I believe, like I said, there's such an audience of people, especially the grandmothers, that they love that stuff. We all have a quilt or something that is sentimental to us in some way. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
From that was passed down through our family or something like that.
I've got two. One for each girl. My grandmother quilted she quilted all the time. So each grandchild got a quilt when they went to college. Mm-hmm. My sister and I got two quilts apiece because, we were the youngest and there were some leftovers. Mm-hmm. But, I got my favorite two. My sister got her favorite two. Mm-hmm. Luckily, that worked out. There was no fighting between the two of us. We had different, styles. And then my girls now each have one quilt.
I got to dig mine up, but I have some that's passed down through the family line from the hills of North Carolina. So that's happening again on March the 1st.
Take advantage of it. It's going to be a special, way to celebrate our heritage.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
So we're very excited about that. Another thing I want to share now, months in advance, I have just gotten word that we are going to be receiving a fine arts exhibit from the Mid-American Arts Alliance and in partnership with the National Endowment for the Arts called Princesses and Savages, The Persistence of Native American Stereotypes. Mm-hmm. And we will have that on display, months from now. It'll be November through January coming up. So we'll be celebrating Native American Heritage Month, and we're trying to put together a whole month or a whole couple months of programming, you know, surrounding this exhibit and it kind of the main piece of it. It all hinged around us being able to secure this exhibit, and I just got word that we got it this
awesome.
Week. So we're very excited about that.
Yay! I'm just drum rolling so much today for
and
everything.
And you know what else is going to happen that month? This is really fun. Red Clay State Park has agreed to come and do a history happy hour. It's going to be a weapons demonstration.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
So that will be fun. That will be fun. That's all coming up in November 2023.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm giving you all plenty of warning. Don't make any plans.
Yeah.
For no, I mean, obviously Thanksgiving is in November and then it starts holiday season.
Right,
but
right.
Save some time for the museum. There's going to be some really cool things happening.
Awesome. And that's the good thing. Once again, if you do not follow us on social media, Facebook, Instagram, do that. Please check our website. Always,
yes,
we
all
try
the
to
time.
Keep. We always keep people updated with what's going on. As you can see, we've gone all the way to November. You know what I'm saying? So it's like when people say, "Well, I didn't know, I wasn't aware." It's like, listen, it's not because we're not trying to give out information.
Mm-hmm.
You just have to follow what we do, and we try to keep everyone updated on everything we have going on ahead of time.
Ahead of time.
You know?
Ahead of time. I mean, there's, you know, people like to say there's nothing that happens here in Cleveland.
I know.
Oh, there's all
people
kinds of stuff that happens
really
here in Cleveland.
Is. Absolutely.
So much. So I'm excited to be a part of that and to bring it to you. But you know who else is making things happen in Cleveland? Is Mike Griffin.
Of course.
Chamber of Commerce.
Of course. We love Mike.
We do love Mike.
We appreciate him.
And he's going to be with us here in just a few minutes. But one thing I guess we do need to let everybody say, we'll remove the facade that this show is being performed live. We actually recorded Mike's interview.
Segment.
Three weeks ago?
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to be honest.
Weeks.
We don't know when we are or where we are, but we do know that we are here.
Uh-huh. We do know.
Today. But what day is today? I don't know.
We don't know. Well, the good thing is that what you see with Mr. Griffin, you're going to get all the information you need about the Rotary Club, all the things, you know, if you want to sign up and become a member. He also enlightened us to a lot of things that are going on
with the Chamber of Commerce
in the city. So disregard anything concerning our language of past tense, present tense, whatever. You're getting a lot of good information. He brought a lot of good information that we didn't even know about.
I know.
So you're going to hear from him. And trust me, you won't be distracted by any of that, I promise.
No, you won't be at all. So we will be right back with Mike Griffin from the Cleveland Bradley Chamber of Commerce. See you in a minute.
Thank you.
And we're back with Mike Griffin from the Chamber of Commerce. How you doing, Mike?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Doing good.
Thanks for having me. Excited to have you today.
Yeah. This is my first time.
I cannot believe that this is your first time on the Bradley
thing.
Beach.
I just knew you had been on the show before, so you got dragged into it today.
I did.
We're happy that you're here.
I did.
I know. I mean, Mike's kind of at the center of everything that happens in Cleveland. You may not know that.
Right.
But
I'll try to be involved. Sure.
Yep, absolutely. Yeah. So tell us what's going on at the Chamber.
Okay. Well, we just started out a new year. We just had our annual meeting this past week. We had 140 more people than we did the year before.
Oh, my goodness.
So we took it from like 220 people to like 360 people.
Wow.
It was, we were turning people away, literally. And it would shock you if I told you how many people that we almost had to turn away.
Oh, my goodness.
Just because we didn't, and we had it at Westmore Church of God. Mm-hmm. So they had to pull more and more tables out.
Mm-hmm.
And the room was still comfortable, but it was a great crowd. We had just we've got, you know, two awards we give out, the MC Hedrick Award, and I shouldn't start talking about awards. Anyway, the two awards and our winners this year were Dwight Richardson won one, and Roger Pickett won the other one.
Yeah.
And they were just, you know, very worthy and great community leaders, and we were happy to present those to them. And we did something different this year. We announced the winners beforehand. So instead of having like the gotcha moment, you know, and you start reading out, oh my God, that's me, and you get up there and you're like, I don't know, you know, why me, or I don't deserve this, or thank you, I don't know what to say.
Sure.
No, we came here, as a matter of fact, and we announced the winners here. Dwight was here, Roger was not available, but we announced it here. It was in the newspaper already, so it really helped promote the event, and I think that helped.
Right.
I'd been to an event like that before that I got asked to come sit at a table for somebody that bought a table because of who the winner was.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
right?
Yes.
And so right. I think the whole thing, doing it that way, helped our attendance.
Right, absolutely, yeah, absolutely. I'm sure it did.
And then, of course, I think also there's just a lot of great things going on in Cleveland-Bradley County, mm-hmm. and I think the Chamber's right in the middle of so much of that. We just announced 3 weeks ago, the single largest announcement for the city of Cleveland ever, SK Foods Group, is coming here.
Yes.
Yep.
In our industrial park, and eventually that will be 840 plus jobs.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
By 2030. Mm-hmm. So that's a lot of families moving to Cleveland. That's
Absolutely.
A lot of people buying groceries and gas and mm-hmm. joining the museum.
I hope so.
Right?
Right.
Because you got to think about it, 840, that's just the workers. That's not their kids. That's not
right.
their spouses.
Right.
And this company is a fantastic company. I don't want to go into a whole lot of detail, but shout out to Doug Berry. Mm-hmm. He worked on that for close to 2 years.
Wow.
And they kept narrowing it down, finally narrowed it down to two locations, and they chose us.
So what is that process like for the Chamber? Is do companies contact the Chamber and say, we're interested in coming to this area? How do y'all get involved and help influence?
It's usually not the company directly, but it's usually either the state mm-hmm. or there's other groups that's their job to go out, site selection.
Mm-hmm.
Companies that go out and find places for companies to locate or relocate. In this case, it's going to be their third facility, and it's going to be larger than the other two combined.
Wow.
So it's really great for Cleveland. Awesome. But yeah, so they visit here. I went to dinner with them a couple of times, get to know them. They get to know the community. We took them to Chattanooga, showed them around in Chattanooga and all mm-hmm. the offerings that Chattanooga has, mm-hmm. which is a big plus for us, being mm-hmm. so close to Chattanooga.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
And so they eventually chose us.
Yeah.
So, and of course, their biggest concern is workforce development.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
and as far as where are the workers going to come from.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And we're blessed to have just opened the Pie Center.
Of course.
And they were able to tour the Pie Center two or three times. And by the time they had that last tour, it was really coming together.
Yeah.
Towards completion. And they are going to actually put a line, like where they can start training people before they get the plant built.
Like an assembly line for whatever
right.
they're... That's really neat.
Yeah.
What type of food products are they producing?
So they don't make anything. Mm-hmm. They assemble sandwiches primarily.
Oh. Okay.
And it's things you would find in a vending machine,
like okay.
maybe at the airport, maybe in a hospital.
Uh-huh.
Interesting.
Worldwide. So yeah, so
Such
they're
a
big.
840 people to make sandwiches.
They're big. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, so we're excited about that.
I was excited mm-hmm. when I saw it online. I was like, wow, this is cool, like
yeah.
you said, for us as a city. You know, in our small city, as people call it, you know, I grew up here, so I'm always happy to talk about how Cleveland has grown over the years. You know, being a little kid, I look at the area we're in, and I'm thinking to myself, when I would go to Lee, and kids would be like, there's nothing to do here, and I'm like, you guys don't know Cleveland and nothing to do. There was a time where Cleveland, none of this existed, so
right.
when
mm-hmm.
I saw that online, I think Mayor Brooks had posted about it, and I was just once again just proud to be from Cleveland, because we
yeah.
really have come a long way. We've really
I mean, I think about just how long was it when I've been married? Since 2005. We've been married a long time, but you know, yep. we got married here in Cleveland, and I remember when we started dating, it was like a 5-year gap, or
yeah.
you know,
yeah.
and there was nowhere to go eat. You could not mm-hmm. get, you couldn't get a beer anywhere. There was one place that we would go to dinner occasionally if I came to visit.
Where was that?
It's where that the Japanese steakhouse is, kind of in front of Staples.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
it
I know. What was it called? I know exactly what you're talking about. I forget the name of it.
I don't know.
But we used to eat there
but
as well.
Yeah, mm-hmm. that was where you would go. And then by the time we got married, there was Cafe Roma was there. And, of course, the museum had opened,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I think, just a couple years ago, in 1999. So between 1999, when Stu and I started dating, when the museum opened, you really did see a lot of development.
Absolutely.
Just in those 5 years.
Yeah, absolutely.
And now I like to wonder, you know, with SK
and the museum
coming
was
in,
a big part of that.
I think it was,
whole,
too.
The whole area.
Yes, yeah. Indeed.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
First Street Square, all of that came
mm-hmm.
up around that.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So going back to the, two things. Manufacturing is... Our manufacturing base, I think it's at 21%
mm.
of our total economy. normally in a community, that might be 8 to 10%. So mm-hmm. when COVID hit, that made a huge difference. Our community was not affected as much as many were, because mm-hmm. most of the manufacturers, some shut down for a week or two, but most of them kept going.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they closed down, you know, for visitors coming in, but for the most part, they kept on working. Mm-hmm. And that kept everybody's, you know, plate full. And so mm-hmm. that's good. And another thing, we talk about new people coming in, but there's also, here's a great, great example. We know Bayer or Beiersdorf, you know, they closed. Mm-hmm. And so they've got a huge, they employed 540, 550 people. Mm-hmm. They closed. That plant, you know, pretty much completely closed. And they had to lay off most of their employees. Well, a new company, mm-hmm. Blessing, mm-hmm. Formulated Solutions,
yeah.
has come in. Hmm. They're hiring up now.
Yeah.
They took over the Coppertone line and several of the other lines that Beiersdorf was already doing. And so they are rehiring pretty much, I would say, yeah. anybody that left is going to have a job.
Yeah.
And so that retains those 550 or so jobs yeah. instead of having an empty shell of mm-hmm. a building out
yeah.
there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So that's huge.
That is huge. Mm-hmm.
That's almost as big as bringing somebody new in.
Oh yeah. Yeah,
Valker has a, you know, a big expansion going on, and maybe plans for even more. Duracell's got growing and adding a new line and doing more there. So we're very blessed in this area.
We are very blessed.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Now talk to us a little bit about chamber membership and why businesses want to be a part of the chamber.
Well, I always say that just bottom line, I feel like being a member of the chamber is supporting your community, mm-hmm. okay? Because all the things we do with workforce development, with tourism, mm-hmm. With our schools, you know, the workforce development is really going in the schools. We've got our leadership, our youth leadership mm-hmm. program. Mm-hmm. We've got the best partnerships where companies partner with a school mm-hmm. to help, you know, pay for activities or go in and, you know, it might be simply going in and reading to the kids or whatever, but they get in the schools and they
right.
get involved
right.
and they expose their company to the students. Mm-hmm. So there's all the things we do in the schools. There's things we do to support our existing industry. You know, mm-hmm. we've got, you know, things specifically for that. And it's recruiting new companies in like we're doing. Because like I said, every new company that comes here, every job that is added or mm-hmm. or retained is going to help whatever business we may be talking
right.
about.
Mm-hmm. Right.
If it's Terra Running Company, if it's Larry down at Town Squire,
right.
I always love to give him a shout out. You know, all our local businesses that
right.
we care mm-hmm. about so much. Mm-hmm. And so to me, by being a member of the chamber, when you support us, you're helping yourself, okay?
Yeah.
Right.
And to me, it's almost like being a good community steward. Really,
right.
I really feel that way. And to me, you're kind of left out if you're not part of it. And mm-hmm. We just had a membership campaign. We added on about 50 or so new members. Wanted to do more, but that's another story. Mm-hmm. But we are going to, we did a video through that. I don't mm-hmm. know if you've seen it, but I'm happy to share it with anybody.
I did see it. I saw it on Facebook. It was a great video.
Yeah,
it really highlighted
yeah.
all the different industry and retail
yeah.
in the area.
One of our chamber members produced it, Rural Rex Media,
mm-hmm.
and we wanted to have something that we could use during the campaign, but also that could be used. Zach Brooks is our mm-hmm. investor relations or membership director, and he can use that to send to a prospect and say, hey, take a look at this.
Right.
This is what we do. And
right.
I told them, I want to tell our story in 2.5 minutes or so, because nobody's going to watch anything longer than that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Right.
And they did a really good job with that. So
yeah.
we've got that as a resource that we can use.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then we mentioned, so mentioned membership, then also Danielle Seals works in workforce development,
mm-hmm.
mentioned Doug. Lisa Fain took over for Bernadette. Everybody knows mm-hmm. Bernadette. She retired after 40 years.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
Come down and we'll take you on a tour of the Bernadette Douglas conference room.
Mm-hmm.
But we're proud of her.
Yeah.
And I was thankful to work with her for 3.5 years. But so Lisa's doing a fantastic job. But and Aaron moved from membership. Aaron Weatherford moved from membership to communications and marketing, and he's
yes.
doing really good in that mm-hmm. position as well. But then Melissa Woody, I think everybody
mm-hmm. everybody knows
everybody,
Melissa.
Mm-hmm. Everybody, she is our, yeah, she's the face of the chamber, really. Everybody knows
yeah.
her, and she does so much, and she's got two big events coming up, the Songwriter event
tonight.
This weekend.
We're excited about it at the mm-hmm. museum. We're expecting about 500 people. course, it's free admissions, free for the community to come in. There's four different food trucks coming. One of them contacted me last night and they said, please be aware we're a 30-foot truck. And I was like,
oh my gosh,
where are we going to put you? I think I texted Melissa a little after 10. I was like, what are we going to do? So come early to get good parking and to get a good seat, because again, it's going to be wall-to-wall seats. Last year it was standing room only. Of course, the museum will have a cash bar this year because we can. So it's going to be just like going to a concert in the big city, guys.
Yeah, we need that.
So, you know, and what I think is so cool about the songwriters competition is that you see all different kinds of music, all different, you know, voices, and it's fun because people are kind of coming and going, and they might play the piano, and they might play jazz, or they might play the blues, or it might be rock and roll, or it might be country. You just never know, and it's all kind of mixed in there together. So if you're a lover of all music, I mean, it's really a fun,
night. There'll be something for you.
There is something for everybody, and then these are all, it's all local talent. It's amazing to me. The amount of local talent that we have.
I hate it. I'm always out of town for it. And once again, I'll be out of town. Yeah. I'm always out of town. Yeah. I've never been to the Songwriters Night. But I've heard nothing but great things about it, obviously. Yeah. But like you, there's so much talent.
Of all people.
Right. Yeah. I'm never here. So I hate that, but I'm excited that that happens every year because it gives a chance to showcase the talent we have right here in the city of Cleveland.
Well, getting back to Melissa, so if you're going to be out of town this weekend, are you going to be in town April 1st for the Hot Slaw and Arts Y'all Festival? There you go. So you can come to that.
Come to that.
And there'll be some entertainment there too. It was a lot of fun. Last year was the first year.
Yep. There's a lot that goes on with that. I know the museum will have a booth at the end of Parker and First Street.
That's good.
We're going to be doing making bees out of recycled materials as part of a, well, it's the Rethink Recycle Art Contest with Keep Cleveland and Bradley County Beautiful. And then we've got an art installation that will be going into our front yard at the museum of, it's a bee awareness campaign that's coming in. So we'll be making those bees at the Hot Slaw and Art Y'all Festival and then installing them on the honeycomb structures at the museum.
That's cool.
Yeah. It'll be a lot of fun. So, well, we are about out of time today, Mike, but I feel like we could talk for... another 30 minutes.
I could listen to you talk about everything, all things Cleveland.
You know, I love this job. It's it's so much fun, and we got a great team. I mentioned, I think I mentioned everybody on the team, but who did I leave out? Of course, we got Melissa Skinner and Tammy Randolph working in the office, and then Mary Tom Cox works with Melissa, and then we have the Darlene up at the Heritage Center, and if you haven't been up there, just to learn about the.
The Cherokee removal
and all that. That's we are. I don't think Darlene's is specifically a chamber employee, but we help finance that. Or you know, Melissa was very very instrumental in getting that built, and it's a great testimony to what unfortunately went on.
What happened in this area. That's right.
I've learned a lot just hearing things that I didn't know. Thank you for everything you do for the community.
Thank you.
I know you probably don't need to hear it, but it feels good to hear it ever so often because you guys make such a great contribution to the city. So thank
you. Well, and I'm also...
Your work is appreciated.
And one last thought on that fact is that... I served on the museum board for
forever.
I was chair for 2 years.
It's gonna be for me. Lucy told me I'm not allowed to never not be on the board. So it'll probably be my story.
He thinks he's not on the board, but he still is.
Absolutely.
Not by choice. It's just because it's in.
You're
my
a member
head.
For life.
Well,
you are.
And I'm a huge fan and supporter and always will be. And
absolutely.
You put a lot of heart and soul into that when I was on the board, and you don't, you know. I just want continued success, and I'm proud of all that y'all are doing today, and you've done a fantastic job.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I'm glad to have your help and your support, and we appreciate all the Chamber does for us.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Good partnership.
It is a great partnership. All right, everybody. Well, thank you so much for joining us on the Bradley Beat, and we will see you next time.